नीतु शर्मा, योर EVS टीचर. टुडे वी आर रीडिंग टुगेदर चैप्टर 1 ऑफ साइंस, लाइफ एंड सर्वाइवल ऑफ प्लांट्स. यू ऑल्सो रीड दिस चैप्टर विद मी एंड ट्राई टू प्रोनाउंस एवरी वर्ड प्रॉपरली. ओके, लेट्स स्टार्ट. अडेप्टेशन, लर्न वेल, पेज नंबर 102. Plantations are living things just like human and animals. Different types of plants grow in different places. They have different features in order to survive in those areas. The special features that allow a plant or animal to live in a particular place are known as adaptations. New words: feature, particular, adaptation. The region where a living thing lives or grows naturally is called its habitat. According to their habitat, plants can be divided into two major groups. Number one, terrestrial plants, land plants, aquatic plants, water plants. Plants that live and grow on land are called terrestrial plants. Terrestrial plants. We find different kinds of plants in different regions like mountains, forests, plains and desert. These places have different soil and climatic conditions. On the basis of the type of soil and climatic conditions of place, terrestrial plants can be categorized as follows: plants in desert, plants in hills, plants in marshes, plants in plains. Desert are very hot and dry regions. Very few plants grow there because desert receive very little rain. Some common plants found in desert are cactus, prickly pear, date palm, etc. To obtain water from the soil and to prevent water loss, desert plants have the following features. They either have very few leaves or no leaves at all. In such plants, photosynthesis is carried out by green stem itself. Photosynthesis. They have spine instead of leaves. The plant draws up water H2O through its roots. The leaves take in CO2 from air. The leaves tap energy from sunlight. The plant uses the energy of sunlight to turn water and CO2 into sugar and oxygen. The plant releases oxygen into the air. The plant uses the sugar for growth. Photosynthesis overview. Spines prevent the loss of water and thus plants retain water. They have thick and fleshy stem that can store water. They have long roots that go deep into the ground to absorb water. Plants that grow in hilly areas and mountain adapt themselves to survive in cold conditions. They have needle-like leaves with waxy coating. They have sloping branches through which snow slides easily. These trees have cones instead of flowers. Plants that grow in hilly areas and mountain adapt themselves to survive in cold conditions. They have needle-like plants in hills, cedar trees, fir trees, spruce, pine trees. Marshy places have sticky and clayey soil and plenty of water. This type of areas are known as swamp. The root of the plants growing in marshes are unable to get air. Therefore, the roots of these plants come out water and soil to breathe. Such roots are called breathing roots. Plants are known as mangroves. The Sundarban mangroves are example of such plants. The climate in plains is neither too hot as in desert nor too cold as in hilly areas. Plains receive moderate rainfall. Trees in these regions have thin and broad leaves so that they can capture a lot of sunlight to make their food. These trees shed their leaves during winter season. Trees such as mango, banyan, peepal and neem grow in plains. Banyan tree, neem tree, peepal tree. Aquatic plants, Lanwell, page number 104. Plants that live and grow in water are called aquatic plants. Aquatic plants grow in ponds, lakes, rivers, streams, and oceans. There are three types of aquatic plants: floating plants, fixed plant, underwater plants. Floating plants float freely in water. To float on water, these plants have the following adaptive features. They have small and light bodies that can float. Example, Wolfia and duckweed. Some plants have spongy and air-filled stems. This makes them light enough to float easily. Example, water hyacinth. Fixed plants features. These plants have roots that are fixed to the bottom of ponds, but most of their vegetation is above water. They have long, hollow, flexible stems with broad and flat leaves that float on the surface of water. The upper surface of their leaves have a waxy coating and stomata to absorb air. Examples, lotus and water lily. Underwater plants. These plants remain completely submerged in water. They have narrow and thin leaves
and flexible stems that offer little resistance to water currents. They breathe through their body surface and don't have stomata. Example, hydrilla, tapgrass. Non-green plants. Some plants like mushrooms and moulds don't have the green colored pigment called chlorophyll. They are called non-green plants. Unlike green plants, they cannot make their own food. They grow on dead and decaying matters. Chlorophyll in plants. Chlorophyll is the green pigmentation or pigment in leaves that help plants to absorb or trap light energy from the sun to make food. Other type of plants. Insectivorous plant. There are some plants that eat insects. Venus flytrap and pitcher plants trap insects with the help of their specially designed leaves. Such insect-eating plants are called insectivorous plants. They derive nutrients from the insects that they trap. Uses of plants. They get food from plants. Plant fibers like cotton, jute, flax are used to make clothes, carpets, and ropes. Stems of bamboo plants are used to make paper, baskets, huts, furniture, etc. Wood of trees like sisam, teak, and sal is used to make furniture, doors, window, etc. Some plants like tulsi, cinchona, and neems are used to make medicines. Gum and rubber are also obtained from plants and are used to make tires and other useful things. So, we complete the reading of this chapter. Stay happy and healthy and safe at your place. Thank you, kids.